morning. It's so good to be here at Joy Fellowship and be in the presence of the Lord. And I want to personally thank you, along with Uriel, for your faithfulness. Joy Fellowship has been with us in the Dominican Republic, believe it, for 20 years. We have been there, and just thinking about all the times we would come home and be here, and all of our children, remember all of our children, there are four of them, which three of them are married. We have one granddaughter, and we have we have twins coming in the spring, our oldest daughter, and we have another one on the way as well. So we're going from one to four. I want to catch up to Charles and Annette. But we just want to thank you so much for your faithfulness to the Dominican Republic. And God is just doing such wonderful, awesome things that we don't have a hand in. It's Him. He's doing it all. And all He's asking for us to do is just to be faithful. And you all have been faithful. So your reward in the Dominican Republic as well. Amen.
Yes, amen. Yes, thank you. We want to show you a little bit of what's going on over there. And so look at the screens. I'm going to sit over there, follow my computer. And if we can turn the lights down a little bit too so that we can see the screens brighter, I would appreciate it, guys up there. So we want to tell you a story. Started 20 years ago. And that's what we looked like 20 years ago next. You know, your pastors are so gracious. When God spoke to us to go over there, we went on the road raising support, and we lived for several months here in Hopewell. Taught some of the kids how to play soccer, and then pretty soon they were beating me. Very smart boys. Then the next one, once the Lord helped us to go to the Dominican Republic, we went to the southern part near the border with Haiti next, and found some really good churches in the main city of Barahona. So I asked the guys, the Christians there, I said, where is there a place here where there are no churches? And they said, yeah. So we went away from the city about 40-minute drive, and we found this place called Cristobal, filled with witchcraft, filled with just all kinds of stuff. We started a church there. We had no money. It was only our home church and Joy Fellowship were the only ones that were supporting us. So a guy there gave us some coconut trees. We made slats out of that and used the leaves for the roof, and we began the church. Then after that, we bought land. Nobody wanted to sell us land there because they didn't want us there. They come and throw rocks at us when we have out of the street meetings. And the next one, we bought property, built the first building in the town of Cristobal. We're going to show you a video of what happened in February of last year. We're going with the same team. This is our church from North Carolina that Annette's third sister, Debbie, and her husband, they started this church called Reimage. So watch this video.
Dios te bendiga!
Hey, everybody on Facebook land. Just like we promised, this is Uriel and Becky Castrillon, my friend Wayne Trainer, team from North Carolina, looking at what God is doing here in Cristobal with the kitchen cafeteria for 200 children that will be soon be sponsored here in cooperation with Compassion International. So we want to show you right behind us. Construction is going on right now from 2 weeks ago when we first talked to you about this project. A lot has happened. There's a roof on it already, windows, the floor is being poured. We're almost there. So we need you guys to continue to pour in the blessings of donations so that we can finish here. And when we're done with this, we want you to look at that fence. It needs to be replaced right over here because it's sharp 10 roof materials. We need to put a chain link fence. So come with us right behind us. We're going to look at what's going on. I'm here with Wayne Trainer from Greenville, North Carolina, and I want to ask him a couple of questions about his experience here in the Dominican Republic. When was the first time that you came here?
2004. We came with a construction team. At that time, the building over there wasn't even here. And we also had a medical team. This year, we're here with Vacation Bible School. And this is my fourth time. And it's amazing seeing the work of the way the children have been brought in. And there's actually youth that were started in 2004 as a product of the Academic and Feeding Center that are actually leading the churches now here in Cristobal and Salinas and Polo.
We're having 500 children a day here from the school. We're going to show you pictures of that, a little bit of video. We're very excited sharing the gospel with them, have a good relationship with the local authorities, and the principal of the school and all the teachers are supporting the work that we're doing. We're very excited about what God's doing here. So why don't you come in here, stand, just show the guys working, and we'll show the people what's going on in the building right now. They're mixing some cement right here and bringing it in. The floor is being poured. This is Brother Sabache.
Mano Sabache.
Lo bendiga. Saludame a los hermanos ahí. He's from our church. He's our master builder here with cement, our mason guy. We got windows already here in place. The roof is on. We got to do some remodeling over here, but this building is happening.
Next, and the building was completed. Let's start this one. It's also a video. That's our church up in the mountains.
Another broken heart comes into view.
That's our second church plant in the town of Salinas. The principal send the teachers with as many classrooms as you want to hear the gospel. 250 children in each service, in the morning and in the service in the afternoon as well. Kitchen and cafeteria, up to 200 children we can feed there. This was this Christmas activity with the children. Next. The kids are just, the town is changing. Next one. Let me show you our first baptismal is the next. That was our first baptismal about 18 years ago. the guy, the little guy on my right, see him? His name is Tomas. He is today our general overseer of our six churches that we now have over there, two new church plants that are being done. To the farthest of my right, that's Ingrid. She's assistant pastor now. Next, that little guy is our pastor from our newest church plant. So we have three pastors just from the kids. So we need to work with the kids. Next one. There's Tomas, the guy in the middle with the blue shirt, the tallest. He baptized all of those young people recently. Now he's doing what he learned to do. Next. He's recently married to a wonderful medical student girl. Loves the Lord, doing a great job. So that church planted another one on the other side of town, which is the next. And we built a temporary rented land there, built another coconut tree, like the building, like the first one we did, because that side of the town, the people can't come to the other side because there's a feud and the family's been fighting and killing each other. So they said, please build us something on this side. Well, that place got filled. We bought land behind this one. Here's Pastor Tomas next, ministering in that building. We bought land next. There it is. About an acre of land, and we started building next, year before last. And here's the building next. Now it sits about 250 people. We just started having services in there next. We need to finish it. As you can see, it's just a cinder block. We need stucco. We need to get chairs, sound system. But the main thing is people are getting saved, and now they have a great place to meet. Next shows our very first wedding in that town. They have never had a wedding there. People just 12, 13-year-olds, they just start living together. Things don't work out. They just move with somebody else. They didn't know anything about marriage. Now all the girls in the church, my wife promised, you will have a wedding like that if you guys will do things like we're telling them to do. You know, not just checking up, but waiting on the Lord and doing things according to the Word of God. They're pastors now too. From that new building that we showed you, they're the pastors there, Adoni and Jordelina. Next, there they are. They made their own dresses. Our daughter Bethany on the farthest left was part of that wedding. And the next one shows education is very important, Christian education, that is. As Pastor Bennett said, it's only the Word that sets people free. But we also have a benevolence ministry next where we pick the poorest families, and we bless their children with shoes. They're part of our program. We have 450 children now sponsored in combination. We're working with Compassion International. They sponsor 200. The government of the Dominican Republic is sponsoring 200 children in our program as well. They know it's Christian-based, and we had 100 already. So 450 children now. When we started, Pastor Bennett remembers, we had like four or five kids, that's all we could do. And now this is what God is doing. Yes. Next, we love to do street meetings. There's Becky playing the piano next. There's Joel Bennett there on the far right doing dance with our two daughters, Mimi and Becky Ray. Next, that's our second church plant, same building we built in Salinas. We own those lands and the buildings, everything is paid for. Every year we do a medical, next, we do medical outreaches in our churches. So people come to the church and they get prayed for, they get medical attention, next. And next, we have a smaller church in the mountains of Polo, beautiful area, next. It's a very pretty part, and this is our pastor, Arcadio, next, that church over there. We have branched out to the city of the northern part of the island, the city of Santiago. Before that, next, which this is Pastor Julia. Her husband passed away a year ago. He had planted these churches, and she's still continuing going on. There's a member of the church that gave that piece of land next, and we're going to build our next church right there for that congregation. Next, this is Luis Miguel. We bought that little building where he was pastoring as well from the same ministry. He is with us. Next shows him and his family, his three little kids and his wife. They're doing a great job We're helping train them as well. The next one shows our third building. All of these buildings that I'm showing you in Santiago, the northern part of the island, we rent there. So the first one we're going to build is for Pastora Julia. The next one shows our pastors and leaders for our annual retreat. We go to the mountains, another beautiful area in the Dominican Republic, and we have 3 days of fun fellowship and some teaching that helps us celebrate what God has done during the year and set our sights on what God will do for the next year. And we are now living in Baltimore, Maryland, and we're under Pastor Mike McDermott. I'm assistant pastor there. We have 3 Hispanic churches in Baltimore. Out of those, Peruvian pastor mentored this young man and his wife that are here. They're in Colombia. So we traveled over there 3 years ago, and they decided to work under us. So we're helping this couple. They started a new church next. This is Tirsun and Zenaida. This is a little church right in the city of Medellin where Pablo Escobar built this area back in the 80s. He was the main drug lord of Colombia, and now the people have brought the gospel there. Let's play it. It's a video. This family here is Pastor Jorhams and his wife, Luz Maria. They are another one of our churches. They're in the middle of the country of Colombia. It's called Planeta Rica. He is a theology professor, and we helped him to get this building. Next shows a video. We were in service there with them. So they were living in a little tiny house, but he had 10 cell groups in different areas of the city. And when we went 3 years ago, he decided to work under us and started the church. And then we helped him get this place last year. And as you can see all the way to the back, this is the second floor of his house. He lives on the downstairs. They're renting. They already outgrew this place. Now we're looking for the next building for them, and hopefully to build the church as well, so that it'll be more of a permanent thing. The next photo shows the same group. Next photo, these are the leaders. We had a gathering with the core leadership. He is a church planter. He has committed each one of these leaders and their spouses to plant another church in the city as well. So that he's training them to be church planters. He has his own Bible school next, because he went to theology school first with the Catholic Church, then with the Lutheran Church, then he was a Church of God pastor. Now he's with us, so he's well-rounded in his theology. And the last picture shows our family. To the farthest right, our oldest daughter, that is the one pregnant with twins now, that's Becky Ray and Nick, her husband. Next to them, from your right to your left, is our son David. He is pastoring. He's campus pastor of the church where we are now with his wife Brooke. And next is our daughter that has our only granddaughter right now and is pregnant. That's Steve and Mimi. Then next to us is Bethany, who is single. She's been a missionary for about a year now in Serbia, former Yugoslavia. Loves it. We're very excited. Youth with a Mission. She's praying, has asked for her to work with them there in Serbia and Europe. So we just thank God for what God has done in the Dominican Republic and what he's doing in our families. Thank you again for your support.